Hello, everybody. Hope everyone is doing well and enjoying their day today. It is Nick here. We are live with another KV Core Lead Generation Masterclass. We'll have a lot of people tune in here and jump on the call. So when you guys do, say hello. Let me know how you guys are doing. And if you guys have any questions, go ahead and jump on, comment those below. I know we have Cabo coming up this weekend, so a lot of you guys might be headed to Cabo, or perhaps you're going to be like on a yacht somewhere in the middle of the ocean, you know, in the, you know, off of Mexico with Amanda and AJ and all those guys. So unfortunately, I won't be able to join you all, but I will be, I think, in Scottsdale. So make sure you get your tickets for Scottsdale as well. Hey, Lisa. There's Lisa. Hey, Lisa. How you doing? Good to see you. Good to see you. So I'm glad you got to make it on the call. So you're here. This is why we're here today, talking some good lead gen stuff. So I'm going to be taking you guys through a really awesome strategy on how to leverage listings on KV Core. And so while I get started, I'm going to get set up here. Again, let me know how you guys are doing down there in the chat. Say hello. Tell me if you guys have any topics or questions too as we go along that you want me to cover. And I'm going to get started by getting everything set. Okay, there we go. I'm all good. Let me go ahead and share my screen. And before I do that, I'm going to just say again, we are talking about KV Core lead generation today. I'm going to be showing you guys a version of how to generate leads through Facebook Marketplace. I've done this training a couple times before, but I'm going to be laying it out step by step. So we're going to get started right now. How to generate leads using KV Core on Facebook Marketplace. All right. So the first step, the first thing that you want to do is you want to go over into this lead engine tab on KV Core. And what you're going to do is you're going to go over here to the squeeze page link. You're going to click on domain. You're going to select your domain. You're going to hit start building. All right. And it's going to take you into this tab right here for squeeze pages. Now, we've talked in a previous video on how to create single property squeeze pages for your listings and how to use those on Facebook, but we didn't go one step further and talk about how to actually put those listings into different groups, how to put it on the marketplace, and how to capture leads from those advertisements that you're putting out there. So I'm going to walk you guys through step by step. So again, you go into Lead Engine, you're going to click on squeeze page, and we're going to head on over to single property squeeze page. Now we're going to need something because we're going to need a listing. So if you guys have a listing, great, use your own. If you want to use another eXp agent's listings or another agent's listing out there in general, all you have to do is get permission from them and then give them credit, you know, somewhere in there. Listed by eXp Realty is usually all that's needed, as long as you have permission from that agent. If you guys are in the Charlotte area, there is a group on Facebook. It's called Charlotte MIYO, Charlotte Make It Your Own. And that is a place where basically you can, anybody who puts their listings on there is giving you express permission to advertise and market their listings. So again, I'm just going to use this as an example. I'm not actually going to go post it, but let's say I wanted to use this listing here, like 373-1982. All we need to do is message the listing agent for that property, and I can go and say, hey, can I market your advertising for like a virtual open house, you know, promoting it online? If they're like, yeah, sure, absolutely, bring me a buyer, great. And I can go ahead and use a listing. So I'm going to use this one here, 373-1982. And what I'm going to do is put that right here, 1982. I'm going to put that listing ID under this squeeze page here under single property. And most importantly, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this property views allowed before registration, and I'm going to change this from 2 down to 1. All right. And the reason why I'm going to do that is because this is going to allow me to immediately force register anybody that clicks on this link. Again, we've talked about this in a previous video. I'm just covering it again because I got a lot of feedback on this that people really got some good value at it. Actually, I had a couple people message me and said they got leads directly after watching this video. So that was pretty nice to hear. So I wanted to take it a step further for those of you that have listings, or again, maybe are part of a team or have a colleague that has an awesome listing that you'd like to promote. and then you get permission from them to do so. So again, we're just going to take a listing ID for a listing here. We're going to put this into a single property squeeze page under Lead Engine. We're going to change this property views allowed before registration to 1. Okay, and I'm going to have this right here, this 1, okay? And again, you're just going to take, you know, like an MLS ID from that listing, all right? And that's all you need to create the link. So after you've changed this to 1, you've put the listing ID, you just simply generate that link. And then once you do that, you're going to see right here that it's going to generate these 2 different links. Now, both of these links go to the same place. All right, so both of them are going to send them right to that single property squeeze page, and it's going to capture their information. All right, now both of these are going to be able to capture leads, but obviously you want to use the shorter one because it's, you know, it's not as long as the other one. It doesn't look as messy. It's nice, clean, and easy. So you can just copy by clicking that button there, copy that link, and now what you're going to do is you're going to take this link and you're going to use it on Facebook under Marketplace. So what you want to do is you want to go into Facebook Marketplace. So you go into Facebook, and it's usually on your home screen. You can just click onto Marketplace. And what you want to do is you want to go and find your way over to Home for Sale or Rent. All right, but obviously we're going to do this for sale. So you want to find your way over to Home for Sale or Rent. And I'm going to walk you through the process. This has changed a couple times over the last few years. Facebook's kind of like changed everything here. You know, you may want to grab a picture or two, obviously from you know, from this site, so you can take some of these pictures and put them on here. Again, make sure you get permission if it's not your listing. Okay, so what I would do is I would take a couple of these pictures, put this right onto here. Obviously, I don't have the picture for this person, so I'm just gonna put like my headshot or something here. Maybe I'll put something funny there. I'll just put the listing picture that I put for today for today's training. So again, you might want to just grab a couple of the images there that you guys have of the listing and upload those. All right, you can even do this mobily now. It says they just added that feature. That's pretty cool. You're gonna go over here and select home for sale, right? You're gonna put the property type, you know, whether it's a house or a townhome or anything. So I'm gonna put house, you know, put the information, it's 4 bedrooms, 3 baths, right? You're gonna put the price, I think it was like $380,000, something like that. You're gonna go and type in the address. So this one is 692525 Troika Court, it looks like. Oh, there it is, popped right up. And you just click it on the map. There it is. It should show up. And you can see here that it's creating this description here. And then what you want to do is I usually hit return about 2 or 3 times. And I put this link here just to have it there. Okay. But then what I do is I'm going to take maybe the first like 2 or 3 sentences of the MLS description. I don't usually take the whole thing because then it kind of gets really long, but some, you know, it'd be totally fine to do the whole thing as well if you wanted to. So, you know, some people just go and take the entire MLS description. They go over to Facebook and you can put the description in there. I personally just think it's kind of long because, again, guys, we're trying to do this to generate leads. We want to be able to capture buyers and sellers here. So for me, the most important thing is the link. And if the link's going at the bottom, I don't usually give them like everything necessarily, right? Like I'll maybe use half of it or something like that. And then what you want to do is you want to hit return a couple times, like I mentioned, and you want to type this sentence in here. For more pictures and information, click the link below. And then you can, you know, you can either do like a couple of hyphens and a little arrow. You could even go in and do something like grab, you can go and grab like, you know, an emoji or something. I have like a page saved in my notes of emojis for some of this stuff. I usually have like a template I just copy and paste, right? But you want to put the MLS ID. You want to put something like this that says for more pictures and information, click the link below. And then you want to put the actual link from KV Core that you created. All right, so those are like the 3 elements there, the MLS description, this little bit, and then put the link. The reason why it's important to put that link is because that link will now show up in your ad. People who see the pictures, or in this case, the 1 picture, and then read the couple sentences, they're going to, just like anywhere else, you see something that catches their eye, They're going to want to see more information. Then what do? They click the link. It goes to your page, and it's going to register them as a lead because it's going to ask them for their information. And so, again, you can go and put in some of the details here. You know, you can put, you know, 2,000 square feet. You can fill out this stuff. You don't necessarily have to fill out all this stuff. That's why it's optional, you know, for these things here. And then what's cool is that now you have the draft saved. You have all this stuff. So you followed through. Again, you went through all these things. These are self-explanatory. And then you went in and you put the MLS, some of the MLS description, maybe, you know, most of it, maybe not all of it. You put, you know, four more pictures of information, click here. You put the link that we got from KV Core, right? And now what we're going to do is we're going to hit next, and you're going to see that you can actually post at one time up to 20 different groups all at once. And the reason why this is pretty cool is because, especially if it's your listing, you can quickly market to thousands of people with the click of a button. You don't have to create this and then manually go and share and share and share. You can all at once post it to Marketplace and up to 20 different groups all at once on Facebook immediately. And this is such a powerful, powerful thing to do, especially if you are a listing agent and you have a listing and you want to get, you know, obviously this is a hot market right now. And so this is very, very applicable maybe a year ago when it wasn't necessarily so hot for sellers. And there was a lot of people that really were trying to get advertising, a quick organic, you know, reach for their listing. And this is a great way to do that. And so you can go and share up to 20 different groups. So if you are on Facebook and you're looking for different groups to go in and, you know, find, you know, a place to share, you might want to search for different things like this, like homes for sale or rent, North and South Carolina here. So like this is a, you know, a good place to advertise your listings. You have realtors that are in here that might bring you a buyer client, right? But you also have people that actually legitimately look for homes in here and will go in and register on your website, right? So you can see like I'm a member of like a whole bunch of groups. And what's cool is, again, I could go through and I won't do this because you want to be careful not to post the wrong thing in the wrong group, right? But I can legitimately go through and click into like 20 of these different groups. And I could go ahead and post my listing right into all of those groups all at once. All right. So does that make sense for everybody? I'm checking on the comments in here in these different groups just to make sure that or in the group rather that everyone is on the same page. Chris Snow obviously has got some awesome lead conversion training coming up in a little bit and everything. So, Chris, I hope you're doing well out there, man. But as far as this process goes, right, as far as going through these steps here, taking a couple of lines from the MLS, you know, using this kind of verbiage here. And again, if it's not your listing, I should mention, again, if it's not your listing, but you got permission from somebody, you know, you want to put the brokerage listed by, you know, I put like EXP Realty if it was an EXP agent, right? So I put listed by EXP Realty. You don't necessarily have to give credit or put the information necessarily, but again, check it. Maybe different in different states, so check with your state broker. But most of the time, because the listings are actually held with the brokerage, you can just say listed by EXP Realty and be just fine. But you don't want to make it seem as if it's your listing if it's not. Definitely give credit or at least put that it's listed by the brokerage. And then you can put this information down below. But, you know, you could also just put listed by the listing agent or, you know, whoever it is as well. But that doesn't mean you necessarily have to put their information, you know, their contact number or especially their website. Because, you know, you're promoting it. You're going to try to bring the listing agent a buyer. It's no different than how you would use this in an open house. So this is a really awesome strategy for a Facebook marketplace that leverages listings, helps attract a lot of buyers. And what's interesting, guys, is that you can do something very, very similar using a seller squeeze page or a market report link on Facebook. And these two links, again, like Here for Sellers, has been super, super hot for a lot of different agents around the country and some of the mastermind classes that I teach. Because, you know, obviously right now it's a very hot seller market. You know, they've got a lot of buyers, a lot of multiple offer situations. It's very, very tight. A lot of areas, a lot of listings are going super fast. And so you can use a similar strategy. You won't obviously list the seller squeeze page under a listing because it's not one listing. But these different groups that you can go out, excuse me, and join, these different groups here are all places where you may be able to offer value to anybody that's looking out there for something like a seller squeeze page. Like you can say, hey, you know, a bunch of listings going really hot. Has anybody else noticed that? You know, it's a super tight market. It's a great time to sell. If you want some more information, click here. This kind of page right here, like if I just put in something like Charlotte, or if I was to put in like a subdivision or a county or a zip code, it's going to give you the average price point of that area. I think I have to hit space. Let's see. There it is. It's going to give you the average price point of the area when you create a page like this. I'll show you what it looks like. And so it becomes a very good lead magnet, especially for sellers, because what does it do right away? It's going to allow them to, it's going to allow you to capture rather their information. And I think I am sharing on like a couple, I have StreamYard and a couple of things sharing on my screen. So it might just take a second. But it, what it's going to do again is it's going to allow you to pull addresses and collect seller information because it's going to say, hey, here's the average price point in this area. And I'm not sure why it's taking so long. Maybe try it on incognito. Might be because I have a whole bunch of stuff running, but that wouldn't make sense either. So let me see if it'll load. Oh, here it is. It loaded on the screen. So get it, like average price point of Charlotte, $753,000. What's yours worth? Obviously, that's why a lot of times this stuff kind of works better on more specific areas. So if you were using, so again, if this was like for a neighborhood or something, perhaps you can get real specific, you know, for a specific neighborhood. Like you could type in a subdivision, and it's actually going to give you a more accurate, you know, it's going to give you more accurate numbers because it's a smaller area. It's not like a huge city that is going to value, obviously, the higher range numbers that sit there on the market. And so it's going to show you, you know, the average price point. And the idea is that you can take that link and you can put it onto Facebook and some of these groups, especially for buyers or for sale by owners, anybody that's, you know, looking for something like that. Again, be cognizant of some of the rules and things there. Like you can see here, you know, average price of Skybrook's $550,000, which is much closer to the average there. And some of those areas and groups, you know, there will be people that will put in their address. They download a CMA or a market report automatically from KV Core, and then you're able to capture their address, their information, and reach out to them. And in today's market, this is, those kinds of things have been super effective. And again, you can use those in these groups to really push for things like seller leads. So those are just a couple examples of some ways in which you guys can generate buyer and seller leads, leveraging things like listings, leveraging some of the tools in KV Core, you know, leveraging some of the resources like these squeeze pages that I just showed you today. And again, the point is you want to make sure you go in and join a lot of these groups on Facebook. You want to be leveraging and using Marketplace, leveraging your listings. These are all tools and resources you have at your disposal that can be very, very effective in capturing leads. But as always, make sure that all roads lead to Rome, right? All roads lead back to your KV Core site. So join those groups and you know, add value, like other posts, engage in some of those groups and whatnot. But then make sure that when you're posting, don't ever post something to Marketplace or on Facebook or in one of those groups without putting a link back to your website. That link is like the gatekeeper. It's the key that unlocks the door to you starting a relationship there, because you're going to capture their information. It's going to register them into your database, can start a campaign, get them into your CRM. And that is what is ultimately most important, because then you can start nurturing and converting them using you know, so many different strategies out there, your scripts, your campaigns, all that really good stuff. So let me see if we got any questions here. It looks like, hey, Lisa is back again. So she's asking, the leads that show up in KV Core, will they show up as a new lead? That's a great question, Lisa. Yes. So if leads come into your KV Core system from a squeeze page, like a single property squeeze page that I showed today going into Marketplace, they will show up in your system as a new lead. So Lisa, if you have some new leads that are in your KV Core system that were just generated recently, you might be wondering, where the heck did I get these leads from? Well, they probably came from people that were searching you. Maybe they found you on Google, maybe they found you on Facebook, or they have your business card and it's got your website on there, and now it's linked to KV Core. Well, guess what? They probably clicked on or searched and went on your website and it said, hey, you know, we'd like to send you some more information. Would you like to view more details? And they said yes, and then they put in their information, and that's how you got those new leads. So if they're coming from those different areas, they will come in as a new lead, and those are new opportunities for you to connect with. However, the one situation where they don't come in as a new lead is when they actually come in through the seller squeeze page, because when they come in through the seller squeeze page, they actually come in as a prospect. And that in KV Core kind of lingo, the prospects are basically new leads, seller leads. You can use them in kind of a different way. You can kind of use that that status. You can kind of group it and categorize it as something different. Personally, I use prospects as to label leads that are kind of more long term or more nurture. But if you see a new lead that pops in there that's labeled prospect, that most likely means that they clicked on it as a seller and you got their information somehow, like their address and that kind of information. And so that's how you kind of distinguish it. But it would also label them as sellers as well, so you can see that in your KV Core system. But that's a really great question. And so, you know, if you guys follow through these steps and post onto Facebook Marketplace, you post into those different groups, you join some of those groups, use your listings in those groups, you're going to see some pretty good results. We've been doing this for a while now. I had a team that I was doing this with. I was doing this personally and coaching some other agents to do some of this stuff. It was, you always get some really good results on there because there's always people looking. You'll see people that just click on there. You see a lot of investors too. Some agents, for some reason, don't like to work with investors, but there's a ton of investors. I've worked with a couple of investors who bought multiple properties now and who found me on Facebook. It seems like investors are always on Facebook looking for new opportunities and things like that. And if they're willing to work with you, they can be some really good repeat clients. So use this information, guys. Check it out. If you guys, again, obviously, if you want some jumpstart help, if you want extra additional above and beyond help, and you're like, look, I want to just have you do some of this stuff for me and get me started, you can obviously check out learnkv.com for more information to have my team and I jumpstart your CRM and do some work for you, make your website look better, all those different things, custom campaigns, the whole nine. Check it out, learnkv.com. And until next time, I will see you guys all later. What's up, guys? It's Nick. Thanks for checking out my channel. If you like this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up and hit that subscribe button, because I post so much content on how to dominate the competition digitally. So if you're a real estate agent, an entrepreneur, or a business owner who wants to have better marketing, shoot better videos, and create more sales, make sure to hit that subscribe button. You can connect with me everywhere on social media at Real Nick McCree. And as always, I want you guys to take the value that you learned in this video and implement it into your business right away. So that's all I got to say. Again, thanks for checking out this video, and I'll see you guys on the next video. See ya.